Hi. Oh, guys, I'm Charlotte. I am a second-year Bachelor of Nutrition Science student here at Monash, and I'm also the president of the Nutrition and Dietetics Society. So today I'm chatting to two nutrition and dietetics graduates to find out a bit more about where their degrees have taken them and what their careers look like since graduating at Monash.
So my name's Kiri. I am a remote generalist dietitian in Northwest Queensland. I work for an Aboriginal medical service called Gidji Healing. As part of my role as a remote generalist, I see all kinds of clients from zero through to end-of-life cares, and I'm also recognised as one of the paediatric dietitians for this region.
So I work as a senior food technologist at Hawkins Watts Australia, which is a food ingredients distributor, and I studied the Bachelor of Nutrition Science at Monash and also a graduate diploma in food science at Melbourne Uni.
Going to your kind of career now, Kerry, we'll jump back to you. What would, you know, a day in your life look like?
My day can be very different day to day. So I am based in Mount Isa, so I'm extremely remote. So I'm based here. That's where I am right now. This is where my bed is. And I fly in, fly out, or FIFO, into remote communities of Queensland. So day to day, largely my role is clinical. So it's one-on-one, face-to-face with clients. And with Aboriginal health, you do not know what's about to walk through the door. It could be a 4-year-old with an allergy, a 2-year-old not eating, a 66-year-old palliative care, a 50-year-old type 2 diabetes, newly diagnosed kidney disease. There is no limit to the clinical load that I see, and no limit to the age. And remote really allows you to practice everything. So I practice everything. When I'm not clinical, sitting in a room one-on-one with clients, I'm sitting in case conferences on their behalf. I am advocating for them. Monash University really sets you up to be an advocate for your patients, and I think I do that proudly every day. I sit in big stakeholder meetings, and I really push for the health and well-being of every single one of my clients. I also do a lot of community work, so I do cooking with kids after school, I do recipe creations, we go into one of the recovery centres here and I just do cook-ups with the guys, people who've never really been given opportunities before to cook. It really can change day to day and you just go with it, and it is just a truly wonderful community.
And then how about you, Ying? What's the best or most rewarding part of your role?
For me, because it's project-based, I really enjoy how there's so much variety, there's many different customers, different products to work with, so it's never really boring. And it's really rewarding when, you know, I actually see products on the shelf that I helped to create, and working in a team as well has been really rewarding, just working together collaboratively towards achieving solutions for customers, I think is really rewarding. I'm not saving lives like Kiri, but yeah.
But you know, Ying, exactly what you said. If you work in nutrition and dietetics, you're never bored.
So could you tell us a little bit about how your time at Monash did prepare you for your role?
Yeah, definitely. I thought the fact that we could do internships during our uni degree was fantastic, because not all unis offer it and a lot of them also don't find them for you, which is often the most challenging part. And they give you the option, you know, whether you want to do clinical or industry. So I chose industry and it was quite random. I didn't choose the actual internship. They just assigned one to me. And it just really gave me an opportunity to just do a project from start to finish and really get involved in that whole process. And that sparked, like, it just clicked with me. And I was just like, I really enjoy this. Like, what are the jobs out there that are like this? And so it kind of put me on a path and I started digging, looking more into it, looking at jobs online, their descriptions, that kind of thing. So it made my decision quite easy to move into food science after that.
Could you give a little bit of an elevator pitch for why you think a student could kind of consider pursuing a career along the lines of what you have in remote kind of dietetics?
By choosing to do remote placements and by choosing to be a graduate in remote regions, you not only get experiences that your metro colleagues will never have. My commute to work sometimes involves a plane. if you stay metro, you may only get one ward and you may just do that one disease over and over again every day. And as a new grad, you don't really know what you love yet. You've studied all these amazing things. Some of them were easier to study and some of them were harder to study. Which ones do you actually enjoy doing every day? I didn't know the answer. And so I came out remote and I do everything. You get a lot more professional development and you also generally get a higher pay than in metro, and there's no competition out here. So when I applied for the role, there were 4 other dietitians that applied. So as a new grad trying to enter the workforce, go remote. We are desperate for people. So if you've got the passion and the will, we want you. Sign up.
Thank you so much, Ying and Kiri, for joining us today. I think as a student, this is the best way to learn and be inspired. So thank you so much for your time and for your kind of generosity in answering the questions so comprehensively. If you think nutrition and dietetics, you know, these kind of careers sound like something you enjoy, we hope to see you soon at Monash.